Good evening, ma'am. I am Akanksha Jadhav and I welcome you to our presentation. I would like to start by saying your most unhappy customers are your greatest source of learning. Today, we are here to discuss about study on customers' perception and expectation from ICICI Bank Limited. As we know, ICICI Bank is one of the leading private banks. So first, let's know about the history of ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank was established by the Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India, an Indian financial institution, as a wholly owned subsidiary in 1994 in Vadodara. The parent company was formed in 1955 as a joint venture of the World Bank. The registered office is in Vadodara and corporate office is in Mumbai, specifically Bandra Kurla complex. ICICI Bank works worldwidely and the key people are Girish Chandra Chaturvedi, who is the chairman, and Sandeep Bakshi, who is the MD and CEO. This is a short history of ICICI Bank. Now, let's turn toward our project. How did we gather data? Which technique did we use to convert data into required information, perception, and expectations of customers, etc.? Now, I would like Mangesh to continue further. Thank you.
Mangesh, what happened?
Mangesh, unmute yourself, Mangesh, please.
Sorry, man.
Yes.
Thank you, Akanksha. Hello, ma'am. My name is Mangesh Deshmukh. My name is Mangesh Deshmukh. I would like to introduce our project. In today's competitive world, all organizations are focusing on customer satisfaction. This organization has shifted their focus from earning money to customer satisfaction. ICICI Bank is a good example of this. ICICI Bank is playing a crucial role in the development of this commerce, development of trade commerce. ICICI Bank also being contributing towards the economic development to the nation's through our research. We found out what are the services provided by ICICI Bank, and it is also found that whether they are very innovative, as the competition in the market has increased, as a result the expectation of the customers have also increased. To meet the expectation of the customers, ICICI Bank is making efforts by providing new products with faster delivery at cheaper rates. Thanks, ma'am. Over to Madhav Raj.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Further projects.
Thank you, Mangesh. Hello, everyone. My name is Madhav Raj Shettigar. I am here to present literature review of this research. So, as we all know, Philip Kotler. Philip Kotler is an American author, consultant, and professor. He is also regarded as the father of modern marketing by many scholars. Kotler described satisfaction as a person's way of thinking and satisfaction or dissatisfaction resulting from the relationship of product presentation. Satisfaction level of customers is also affected by their thinking process and values. It is said that satisfaction is a collection of customers' belief about unbiased management. After Kotler, we have Halliwell Roger. Halliwell Roger is affiliated professor of strategy at HEC Paris. In his research, he has described that banks should be targeting only those people who need those services the most. According to him, by using this strategy, customer will remain loyal and trustworthy to bank for longer periods. And lastly, Datta K and Datta A, they have described in their study that the customer satisfaction is the most important key by investigating the perception and expectations of customers in ICICI Bank. Their study proved that the customer are most satisfied with the services of ICICI Bank. They have also suggested that the ICICI Bank should improve their banking services for better outcomes and results. Thank you. Over to you, Aniket.
Good evening, ma'am. The financial performance for fiscal 2020 is summarized in the following slide. The profit after tax of the bank was 79.31 billion after provisions and contingencies of 140.53 billion. Provision for taxes of 61.17 billion. The accumulated profit was 258.10 billion. Taking into account the balance of rupees 178.80 billion brought forward from the previous year, that is 2019, ICICI Bank has a consistent dividend payment history. Bank dividend policy is based on the profitability and key financial metrics, capital position and requirements, and the regulation pertaining to the payment of dividend. Even in this pandemic time, the bank is seeing opportunities to grow and strengthen its franchisee, and it is using these opportunities to further accelerate the digital journey of the bank and its customers. In March 2020, the bank has launched a comprehensive digital banking called ICICI Stack, which offers nearly 500 services to ensure uninterrupted banking experience. Moving on to the next slide, I request Sandesh to continue the presentation. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Aniket. Hello, ma'am. My name is Sandesh Pitambare. Ma'am, audible?
Yeah, but your Hello, voice ma'am? Is breaking. Your voice ma'am, is breaking.
Okay, ma'am. There is connectivity problem. So.
Okay, no problem. You just start.
Am I audible?
Yeah, now you're audible. Please go on.
Okay. Hello, ma'am. Tambare. My friend Aniket has beautifully explained the financial report of ICICI. Not understood the services which of ICICI Bank. So we all know in competition, the bank has to offer services so that latest services so that the customer can avail the services with minimum.
I guess there's some network issues. Anyone can take over this if he's not able to connect.
Okay, ma'am. Can we skip him and next guy will continue the next slide.
Okay, fine. Not an issue. Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello. Yes, Sandesh. Are you able to continue?
Yes.
Yeah, please.
Sorry,
please.
Ma'am, there is a connectivity problem in my village. Ma'am, should I continue?
Yeah, or the next one can continue if there is some issues, because we would be also running short of time, right? So I understood what he wants to say. So the next guy, please continue.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah?
Hello, good evening, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah, good evening.
Good evening, ma'am. Ma'am, my name is Yash. Now yeah. I would like to talk about the research methodology that we used in our project.
Mm-hmm.
It is a specific procedure or a technique used to identify, select, process and analyze information about the bank.
Mm.
The research methodology used to compile data is simple random sampling.
Mm.
Simple random sampling, it takes small random portion of the entire population to represent the entire data set, where each member has an equal probability of being chosen. For example, ma'am, taking decision about to purchase a fruit or not, a fruit merchant inspect randomly only a few of them rather than examining each and every fruit. So simple random sampling, it is basically like a lucky draw. A research can be carried out with the help of two types of data, primary data and secondary data. Primary data is basically collected by research directly, while secondary data, it is a data which is already available and analyzed by someone else.
Hmm.
Since it was difficult for us to collect data directly from the people, so we had done the survey through an online platform by using Google Form within a period of 1 week, that is from 23rd to 28th month. Both primary data and secondary data source of data are being used. Second data was collected from the books, journals and web portal for our study, while primary data collected through a well-structured questionnaires we have put 18 questions in a Google form and 61 people respond to it. In this way, we have collected our data. Now I would like to hand over to Nishigandha. Thank you. Over to you, Nishigandha.
Thank you, Yash. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
My name is Nishigandha Dhange. Now let's see the data collected by us from Google Forms. As my fellow group member explained how we get all data and what are the perception of customers towards the ICICI Bank. With the help of this chart, we got to know that from the 100% customers of ICICI Bank, 85% customers have account in this bank. Then we asked the respondent, which type of account do you have? And here we got to know that 85% respondent have saving account, 13% have current account, and remaining 2% have other type of accounts. In our third question, we tried to find out how much time respondent are connected with this bank. And we are very positive, we got to know that out of 100% customers, 66% are holding their account from more than 6 months.
Okay.
17% customers have account in this bank from last 4 to 6 months, and remaining 17% having accounts last 1 to 3 months.
Okay.
From next question, it is clear that 67% customers are satisfied with interest rates by charge by bank.
Okay.
In next slide. We have also put questions related to trust and reliability. And we can
Wait, Nishu. Hello. Nishigandha, since we are running short of time, what you do is just say the heading like trust and reliability. How many percentage has responded for that? Okay, so cut the time short, okay? Because I need to also ask questions. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Yes, continue. Trust and reliability. Maximum customers gave 5 stars.
Okay.
35% gave 4 stars, and minimum 2% gave 1 star.
Okay.
Then transparency up in charges. Maximum 33% customers are given excellent transparency in charges. Now I would like to request Anand to explain further information. Thank you. Over to Anand.
Thank you, Nishigandha. The quality and services, in that 33% respondent gave 5 stars to quality and services, while 27% gave 4 stars, and the remaining 20% gave 3 stars. Moving to another question, customer care support. In that 58% respondent says ICICI Bank solved their problem in no time, while the remaining 42% says they took time to solve their problems. App support. 67% respondents says app interface is smooth to handle, and the remaining 33% says they face some issue while using the application. Availability of transactional services. So in that 71% respondents says ICICI Bank provide 24/7 transactional facilities. Moving to next, we have asked them credit card users. So in that we get 50% respondents say that they use credit cards provided by the bank, and how they are satisfied with the credit cards. 48% respondents are satisfied with the credit cards payment policy, while 14% are not satisfied. Thank you, ma'am. Over to you, Pratik.
Who is next?
Pratik,
are you there?
Yes, ma'am. I forgot to unmute myself. Sorry, ma'am, for that.
Okay, fine. Let's continue.
Yes, ma'am.
So we have done a further research in our Google form. So we provided one another question like, are they satisfied with offers on debit card? So 50% respondents say, yeah, we are okay with the offer. But 19% says, no, I'm not okay with that. And 31% say, we want to stay neutral. We don't want to comment on that. Then we ask a respondent that are you taken any type of loan from bank? So there is major part in that 21% people say that yeah, we have taken loan, and 79% says no, we don't have taken loan. The reason is in another next question. So we have asked them that are you satisfied the charges which has been occurred on the loan? So 29% says yeah, we are okay with that charges occurred on that loan, but 19% are not satisfied with that, and 52% say want to stay neutral. So we have explained it in further slides why this is a problem. And next we see we ask them about service quality. So 50% respondents say yeah, they have a good quality of services, and 25% respondents say they have excellent quality of services. Then we'll next go to internet banking facility. So according to me, I am also ICICI Bank user. So according to me, ICICI Bank gave best quality of internet banking facilities in this COVID area. It is very important. So 75% respondent are agree to me, like they have provided good services. But and the next we have also asked them, are you going to recommend this bank to other people? So 85% is a large number. 85% people say yeah, we are going to recommend other people. Now thank you, ma'am.
This yeah, thank you.
Now, yeah, Harshal is going to explain limitations.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Now we'll move to the limitation part. So the first limitation is a time limitation. So our research is a kind of a exploratory research. So the more time should be given to the research. But we conducted the research through the Google Forms online medium within a period of 1 week. So this is a short time period, maybe a limitation. Next is a no response. Because most of the peoples ignore the online service. They don't want to take participation in the online service. So obtaining the more and more information is quite difficult. Therefore, it is also a limitation. Next is the accuracy on responses. So generally, public ignores the online survey. The online surveys are not taken seriously by the people. Therefore, there is a probability that some participants may respond to the survey carelessly. So therefore, the accuracy of the survey may be affected. Next is only 61 respondent. So for the good and the efficient research study, the sample size should be bigger and wide. But we included only 61 respondents in our research. So this is a short sample size. There is a chance that may not provide the proper information. Next is the environment. Due to the COVID era, face-to-face difficult with the persons is become very difficult. Therefore, the accuracy of gaining the data may be affected adversely. So this situation can lead to the accuracy of the survey negatively. And next is the lack of knowledge, because our surveys conducted through the online mode and in a very short span of time. There is a possibility that we can't get more and more information. Therefore, lack of knowledge may also be the weak part of our research study. Next is the perspective. So different individuals have different perspective because they see the things in a different manner. Therefore, there is a chance that their the actions would be biased on a particular things of a particular organization. So therefore the perspective may also be a limitation.
Okay.
So thank you, ma'am. Over Welcome. To you, Diksha.
Yeah.
Thank you, Arshad. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
This is Diksha Ujjagre. Now, coming towards the sessions, as from the research, I came to know about the problem customer facing. As we can see, there was some positive as well as some negative responses too. So, coming back towards the point, the first point is regarding loan policies and rate of interest. As we see in our data analysis, that interest rate of loan is high. So, people refuse to take loans. Either we can say people were afraid of taking loans. From the pie chart, we come to know the ratio of 79 to 21. Second point is share relevant information about our services and products. Some of the customers in their hectic lives, they
have some problem in the this thing network. Some problem in the network. Yeah, some network issues you are facing.
Yes, ma'am. I think there is a network issue.
Yeah, who can take over? Please finish it as soon as possible, so that I can start asking questions.
Okay, ma'am. Over to you.
Am I audible, ma'am?
Yeah. You are.
Yes, Diksha. Just a second.
Pratiksha, can you please take over? Actually, we don't have that much.
Second point.
Diksha, it's okay.
Pratiksha, please take over.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Thank you, Diksha, for suggestions. And hello, ma'am. Good evening.
My name
is Pratiksha. As per the information provided in above slides and explained by my fellow group members, I would like to conclude our project of study on customer perceptions, expectations from ICICI Bank Limited. ICICI Bank is not only the largest bank, but also it is considered as the bank which provides all type of services like offline and online banking. Here we have conducted one survey on customers' review, which clearly shows the popularity of bank. From our analysis, we have concluded that people are satisfied with the services and like to prefer ICICI Bank for saving account rather than any other account because of its attractive rate of interest and comfortable repayment system. Ma'am, from our survey, we have also concluded that people have perception that saving account is much more preferable than current account due to inconvenient documentation. ICICI Bank is diversified bank and has extended its operations into different areas like mutual funds, insurance, etc. The quality services and customer care services provided by ICICI Bank are also excellent, and that's why this bank is increasing its customers' review. Also, ICICI Bank has worked hard in the banking domain, and as a result, very less people are dissatisfied with the services provided by ICICI Bank. Now, I would like to request Pratik to explain the further presentation. Thank you, ma'am. Over to you, Pratik.
Ma'am, we have also prepared about bibliography. So, can we continue or is it too
late? It's okay.
To...
Bibliography is no need. So, okay. So, okay. Yeah. So, okay. Good evening all. And it was a kind of a nice presentation and kind of informative as well. And I'm happy that you people have put in so much effort. Right, I wasn't expecting so much effort, but still, since we are in the COVID stage and we are working from home and all those stuff, so we had enough time to prepare. I'm so happy the presentation has come out really well. So certain points you people have put in, which shows that you have done a good research, right? So my question is, what is your perception? Being a customer, what is your perception about ICICI Bank? What is your perception?
Actually, ma'am, ICICI Bank is doing great. Actually, I'm a customer of ICICI Bank. And from my perspective, they are giving a good quality of services. but in some level they are a little bit less. If we compare HDFC and ICICI Bank, then HDFC is more good than ICICI. So and ICICI, I talked with one manager here in my nearby branch. So they are doing some taking some effort, extra effort to improve their qualities.
Okay. So according to you, ICICI Bank is good and private sector banks are doing well, right? During this COVID also, private sector bank is doing well, right? So like many people, they don't want to take loan from ICICI Bank. Why? What is the reason?
Because, ma'am, I think people have the perception that government bank has the lowest rate of interest and a private sector bank has a much more rate of interest compared to government bank. But I think ICICI Bank also have that facility that people can afford that rate of interest and can take the loan from it.
Okay. So, yeah, it's good. I mean, like, we are running out of time. If I go on asking questions, we won't be getting time, right? So,
sorry, ma'am. Sorry to interrupt. But, ma'am, we can rejoin again. So.
No, that's okay. No problem. So, I have got whatever I wanted to ask you. So, what would be your suggestion for further improvement?
Ma'am, first of all, they want to improve internet facility, means internet banking and everything. Because in this COVID area, not everyone is not able to go there. Then the loan policies. So that if they revise their loan policies, then people will get come to know and people will go to bank and take loan. After that, they haven't provided each and every detail on the product. There are some products like some policies and everything. They haven't provided every detail on that. So my suggestion is that they should provide every document and every detail to customers so that customers come to know how we use the facility and everything.
So in short, ICICI Bank is good, right? In short, ICICI Bank is good. Everyone should be going for that, but there are certain lacuna which they can, do it better, right? So that like more customers can go, right? So anyways, bachcha log, it was a good presentation. I'm happy. Okay. And good going. You have done a wonderful job. So I'm happy with the kind of effort you have put in. I wasn't expecting, but still you have put in. So is really good. And congratulations to all of you. You have done a wonderful job. Okay. Thank so you. With this note, bye and take care.
Thank you
so much, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Bye. Bye.